Two things that truly infuriate me about EV charging, and I can't wait to share them with you once I calm down from what might be the UK's worst public charger experience. Thankfully, I don't get angry very often. After 6 years driving an EV, I know that most people charge their EVs at home. Range anxiety is often exaggerated, especially with more public charge points popping up. For long trips, you will probably need to use a public charger at some stage in your EV journey, but they're easy to find through apps or your car's navigation system. However, using a public charge point can lead to a new type of anxiety, charger rage. And it hits me in two ways. Firstly, it's the newbies. They clog up chargers because they don't know how to use them. Watching them fumble around trying to start the charging process or register for a new app is frustrating for experienced EV drivers. After all, we choose chargers based on speed, location, and reliability. But even seasoned drivers can become victims. Sometimes you rely on a charger you've never used before, and suddenly you find yourself in the same boat, struggling to download an app and add payment details with a poor mobile signal. That's exactly what happened to me at this charger in Kirby Lonsdale. Picture this, you've been driving all day and you need a quick top up to get the last 40 miles home. The charger rage was real. It took longer to install the app than to actually charge the car. And let's not forget the expense. Not just the charging fee, but the meal deal the family managed to grab while I toiled away in the car park. Thankfully, the UK government has acknowledged the serious problems caused by charger age and introduced the Public Charge Point Regulations 2023 to tackle it head on. This legislation includes a range of measures to improve the experience of using public charge points with a major focus on ease of payments. Essentially, any new charge point in a publicly accessible location, such as supermarkets, hotels, tourist locations, or even office complexes open to the public, with a rating of more than 8 kilowatts, must now offer various payment options, including the really simple contactless credit and debit cards. The regulations are retrospective for existing chargers rated at 50 kilowatts and above. So by November of this year, this charger needs to be fitted with a payment terminal. And that's what we like in the electrical industry, a forced solution. Good business for electricians. Many business owners are enthusiastic about providing EV charging facilities for their customers, yet they may not fully grasp the legal requirements of setting up a basic charging station. Thankfully, as we'll explore later in the video, the right charging software platform can significantly ease this burden. Many EV charger installers are also new to the industry, so this video aims to guide you through implementing a reliable payment solution. While the process may initially appear daunting, we believe that you'll find it straightforward with the kit that we've selected. And as with many aspects of EV charging, creating an ecosystem of components and services is crucial for delivering effective solutions. That includes the charger itself, installation equipment, and software platforms. And although many installers may already be familiar with these solutions, integrating a physical payment terminal presents a new challenge. To illustrate, we'll enable a payment solution for the Garo Entity Pro charger that we showcased on the channel a few months ago. While we could install a payment terminal directly on each charger, EV Tower have produced a brilliant solution for doing that. This may not be the optimum solution, since many AC chargers are typically installed in a single location where vehicles tend to remain for longer periods. So adding a terminal to every unit would be costly and result in a lengthy payback period. Instead, the solution we'll show you today allows us to pair one payment terminal with multiple chargers, creating a more efficient and cost-effective approach. Note that according to the regulations, the payment terminal must be located reasonably close to the chargers. Now, they don't say how reasonably, but placing the terminal inside a restricted access building or on a different street would probably not be allowed. EV Tower has developed this versatile mounting solution to support multiple EV charger installations, creating a more efficient and cost-effective approach. Alongside housing the payment terminal, this adaptable tower can integrate various ancillary items for EV charger installations, including power distribution, circuit protection, Ethernet switches, and communication infrastructure like Wi-Fi hotspots if you need them to support the chargers. We've configured the tower to house the payment terminal alongside the controller board and Ethernet connection, and we've also included a lighting kit with a water cell, a feature that is sadly missing from many EV charging locations. Moreover, a 4G connectivity antenna is also available for remote locations that lack hardwired communication network. So you could say this tower serves as a sort of central hub for all the equipment related to commercial EV charger installations. You can even install two chargers directly to the unit for smaller installations, creating a streamlined EV charging solution combined with the payment terminal. So let's look at this payment terminal designed by Crane Payment Innovations, or CPI. We find a robust and a rugged device that supports both contactless and chip and pin payments through its card slot and LCD touchscreen. The screen is customizable to fit various applications. For instance, if multiple charging bays are available, users can select the specific bay for their vehicle via the touchscreen. Additionally, the terminal features a smart proximity sensor that powers down when not in use and activates upon detecting users. The electrical installation is straightforward, only requiring a USB connection to the controller board located within the tower, along with a 24 volt DC low voltage connection also housed in the tower. Lastly, the controller needs an Ethernet network connection for cloud connectivity to enable payments. CPI supplies the terminal hardware and serves as the payment platform provider, facilitating secure communication between the terminal and the banking system to ensure safe payment processing. Payment processing is a specialized industry where CPI truly excels. The next step in our solution involves integrating the payment platform provider with the management system for the EV charger, effectively linking the power consumed to the payment made through the customer's card. It's important to note that per the public charge point regulations, this integration must occur without requiring users to download an app or register for a service. Charge point operators can still provide preferential charging rates and enhance features through their apps. To connect the charger to the payment platform, the installer must configure the Open Charge Point Protocol, or OCPP, settings within the charger. We've previously discussed the functions of OCPP in another video that you might find helpful after this one. However, in summary, OCPP allows the remote management of EV charging processes by third-party platforms, which typically offer a broader range of services than the original manufacturer's software, especially regarding customer billing and managing multiple charge points across various locations. Choosing a third-party OCPP provider is crucial, particularly for public charge point installations. The public charge point regulations impose several stringent requirements on charge point operators, including maintaining a network reliability of 99%, which must be regularly reported, and providing a free 24/7 helpline for users. Therefore, quickly identifying faults remotely is vital, and an easy-to-use system that can significantly reduce help desk calls would also be highly recommended. For this integration, we've chosen the Clenergy EV platform, which provides an exceptional back-office solution that continuously adapts to the needs of charge point operators. In compliance with the regulations, they also offer dedicated helpline support for end users. While this video primarily focuses on the payments, the Clenergy EV platform offers a comprehensive suite of features ranging from energy management to the intricacies of managing electric vehicle fleets at home, in the workplace, and at public charging stations. And finally, we come to the charger itself. While most chargers are compatible with the OCPP standard, those intended for billing customers for energy consumption must be equipped with an electricity meter that complies with the Measurements Instruments Directive, or MID. So this is the theory behind implementing the solution. What's it like in practice? Well, I've successfully installed the payment terminal into the EV tower enclosure, connected the controller board, hooked up the Ethernet connection, and powered it on. That is the physical installation complete. Then I updated the OCPP settings in the charger via the Garo app to redirect them to Clenergy and enabled app access. Additionally, I provided the charger ID from the app and the serial number of this payment terminal. So from the installer's perspective, my work now is complete. The rest of the setup is now handled remotely by Clenergy. And once complete, we can see the graphics on the screen changed to the Clenergy platform. So let's give the system a little test. I've connected connected the world's smallest electric vehicle to the charger and selected Start Charge on the screen. The payment terminal recognizes the connected car, matching the ID provided by Clenergy EV. If multiple chargers were installed at this location, they would be listed here. I simply tap a bank card or use a digital wallet such as Apple Pay to initiate the charging process. Although regulations specify that contactless payment is acceptable, the CPI terminal also supports chip and pin payments, which is useful for those who remain cautious about contactless methods. Once the payment is accepted, the charging process begins. Once I've completed charging, I can return to the payment terminal and request a receipt. What's noteworthy is that I've successfully charged my vehicle without having to download any apps or sign up for a service. The public charge point regulations include several requirements that this setup can easily meet. I can quickly identify who operates the charger by scanning the QR code. I can access the terms and conditions, including pricing in pence per kilowatt hours. This process has proven to be both straightforward and efficient for installers. Additionally, we've launched a service to assist end users in navigating the new regulations and mitigate lots of their responsibilities. I'll include links in the description for all of the services and equipment highlighted in this video. If you're interested in installation challenges that can be addressed with the Garo Entity Pro Charger, check out the video that's currently on screen. And if you have any questions regarding the Public Charge Point Regulations 2023 or any other aspects of charge point management, feel free to share them in the comments.